I know that you are socially conscious. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I would call you political, but you're definitely outspoken.
Yeah, I don't like, I'm not into politics.
So what did you,
I have opinions.
What did you think of Ferguson and what you saw going down there?
Don. What did I think of Ferguson? Yeah. I'm disappointed.
Because?
I'm disappointed in the way that, like, it was handled from the government side. I think that that officer should be punished because that was excessive force. That was excessive force. You know, all those shots, where those shots were, the idea that that child laid in the ground, he's a child. I know he's 6'2", 6'3", something like that, but he's a child, okay? And he was laying in the ground for hours. That kid didn't ask to get killed. And so I feel like that officer should be punished, but then, like, at the same time, like, we got to start looking at ourselves, too, because we are feeling hunted, and we need to be able to avoid these things, and sometimes it's unavoidable.
Did you see this whole Facebook campaign about your jean designer, about pulling up your pants, like, don't give the man one more thing
that ain't the
to
man.
Go after you?
Who is the man? Who is the man to tell me how I can wear my pants?
Mm-hmm.
Can't nobody tell me how I can wear my pants? I'm a human being. So that's the thing. There's so many issues that keep being lumped summed in the same issues. Wearing your jeans on your butt or below your waistline has nothing to do with being black. You know how many white kids do that?
Justin Bieber, they
okay,
all do.
Okay, so then that's not a black or white thing. Hoodies are not a black or white thing. It's an excuse.
So
in certain places, yeah, we're being hunted. But there are good policemen, and there are bad policemen, and there are good kids, and there are bad kids. Regardless to what that child was, he did not deserve to be shot down like that.
What do you mean? How do you avoid that?
When they told him to get out of the row, he probably should have got out of the row. I wouldn't have been in the row to begin with, though. But look, let me make it very clear, because people like to soundbite in this day and age, right? This is the day and age of soundbiting. I love my culture. But I don't want my culture to want nothing from nobody else. I think we can do what we need to do ourselves. And the only thing is, I was disappointed that, like, while we had so much peaceful protesting going on, what the media chose to cover most of all and highlight was the random few people that threw Molotov cocktails, the random people that had guns on them, the random incidents where not random, really, actually, motivated, but like some of the rioting that was going on, and some of the looting of the stores, and the looting of the stores in our own neighborhoods. I'm not telling you to do it nowhere else, but damn, why are you doing it in your own neighborhood?
But see,
I didn't get that neither.
The cameras are drawn to where the action is, and I completely agree with you, and that's why we also focused on volunteers and people who were doing good things.
Yeah, but we gotta spend more time on the people that were doing nonviolent protesting, which is allowed in this country.
Agreed.
We didn't spend enough time on that. That's why I feel like the president needs to come down there.
I was going to ask you, what do you think about how the president
needs to come down there. Because when your parents come in the room, whether it's you or your cousin that knocked the vase down, both of y'all sit up at attention and everybody, as my dad would say, tighten up.
So even now, after it's been a few weeks, you still think he should go down there?
This is a deeper laceration in this country. If you think that this is going to blow over, this is going to be the longest hangover in race relations ever. Want to know why? Because we thought we had gotten so far. But now there are certain people that are like, man, they shouldn't put a tape out of him being in the store, this, that, and the other. They ain't got nothing to do with the crime. You're absolutely right. But I come from a black family that, like, my grandma would have said, but let me see that other tape, too.
Mm-hmm.
And you would get a beating for that.
Yes.
Because nothing, no stones are left unturned. No T's are not crossed. No I's are